There's nowhere at all I'd rather be today than here at Hockenheim for the German Grand Prix. We have an incredibly competitive field this year, which means we should be in for a treat. And judging by the sea of people filling the grandstands, there's a fair-sized chunk of Germany that agrees with me. With average lap speeds of around 130 miles per hour, the Hockenheim Ring is a quick circuit with a lap distance of 2.8 miles, around 17 corners. The main DRS zone through Parabolica leads into the hairpin for the best overtaking opportunity on the track. Anthony Davidson joins me again for the race today. Let's talk about Davidson. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
It's been a really solid year so far. There have been some incredible standout performances, but what's really impressed me has been the consistency. With this kind of form, I'm expecting another great race today.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Davidson lines up on pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hülkenberg, Ocon, Carlos Sainz, and Sorokin, Gasly, Stroll, Perez, and Roman Grosjean, Bottas, Verstappen, Kevin Magnussen, and Alonso, Leclerc, Hartley, Sebastian Vettel, and Lewis Hamilton, Ericsson, and Kimi Raikkonen rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, the run into turn one isn't too long, so the pack will be bunched up. Take care. Right, let's get the car up to temperature on this lap. We're learning the gears, so go through them all if you can. No rain expected, no rain expected for the time being. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. Okay, that's a good start. Keep it up. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the softs. We're accumulating some wear on the MG UK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Some information on Verstappen. They've got a serious car issue. It looks like they're retiring. Yellow flag. Okay, clear. Pit window open. Let's box this lap. Remember, box this lap, keep an eye on your distance to the speed limit line as you approach, and make sure you don't speed. Go, go, go! Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Fernando's in for his stop. We're leading our teammate by 30.3 seconds. The energy store is getting worn, reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. Right, some information on Ricardo. They have some kind of mechanical problem. The gap behind us is 20.9 seconds. There's 6 laps of fuel remaining. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. The gap to the car behind is 40.6 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. There's three laps of fuel remaining. Absolutely awesome. Just amazing. Well done.
McLaren have pulled it off. They've won in spectacular fashion here today. So, Ant, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
I feel like consistency was probably the key today. There's being quick, and then there's being quick lap after lap after lap. If you can do that, you can capitalise on other people's errors without making many of your own. And that's an approach that can push you a long way up the field.
And now it's time to wind down and celebrate after that fantastic Grand Prix. Here they come, your top three, out onto the podium.